Good morning, Shabbat Shalom. Wonderful to be here again. Lesson number 8. I trust you enjoy the lessons as we go here through the book of Deuteronomy. Choose life. Why wouldn't you? Makes sense. Look at the memory text. It says here, call heaven and earth as witnesses today against you that I have set before you life and death, blessings and cursings. Therefore, choose life that both you and your descendants may live. You know, the tree of life, access was necessary. And of course, we did forgo the rights to that. There was another tree of knowledge of good and evil. And the word for knowledge in the Hebrew, da'at, is an experiential knowledge, not just a head knowledge. It's something that you experience. And heaven only knows how much evil we have got in this world and how many people have lived through it and are living through it right now. And so we got to bear in mind, none of us asked to be here. That is true. We didn't choose to come into existence. That is true. People say sometimes, I didn't ask to be born. I know that. But I meet very few people who regret being alive. I'm not saying there aren't. By and large, there is a desire to live. And of course, to live life to the full. And so we don't choose our parents. We don't choose the location. But here we are. We didn't even choose to be created in the image of God. And to choose life means to choose Him, to have eternal life. That choice we do have. There is no middle ground. There is absolutely no middle ground when it comes to a decision. Either you obey or you don't obey. And the reality is, disobedience means to death. Obedience will give you life. So to choose is important, and choose you must, because there is no choice not to choose. If you don't choose, you already have lost. There is no neutral position. It just isn't there. Life and good, death and evil, blessings and cursings. God really offers only one thing. And we need to get this from the book of Deuteronomy. God offers one thing. He offers life. Eternal life. That's what's on offer. Because if you don't accept that, you have chosen non-existence. You have chosen, by refusing, you have chosen death. Here we are as a people, before the promised land. It's just before us. Let's determine that we choose life. Let us have the blessings. Let's prepare for His coming. It's not too hard for us. It's not too hard, wasn't even for ancient Israel. God's command is not difficult. It is not mysterious. And I love this simple little statement. This simple little statement. All His biddings are His enablings. It's open to you. He can make you able to live the life He wants you to live. It is a matter of surrender, absolute surrender to the God that we worship. May God bless you as you study this lesson.